Hi everybody, it's Franny, and today we're going to be discussing why horsepower is horse poo. Now the reason I say that horsepower is horse poo is that really all horsepower is a very, very old conversion factor for power. So in order to understand power, we're going to have to look at a few equations. I'm going to try and keep the math to a minimum here, but I've got four little equations I want to put up. I'm going to put them up here on the screen so that we can refer to them back through the rest of this video. So the first one is force. And force is that which is required to accelerate a mass. Newton's equation, F equals ma. Very easy. Second one is torque. So that is a force applied at a radius or a distance. So I'm going to pull here on the wrench and it's going to give me a torque here. So torque is in pound feet. The next one is work. Now work is in foot pounds, and so it sounds a lot like torque, but the only difference really is that we can apply a static torque, but if we manage to push through a distance, we've performed work. So work is force through a distance. Then the last one is the rate in which we perform work, and that's power. So that's just work over time. Simple enough. So getting back to the horsepower, a horsepower is really just a scaling factor, just like kilometers to meters. A horsepower is defined as 33,000 foot-pounds per minute. So where did that come from? Well, it's actually the output of a brewery horse. So it did actually come from a horse. So where did all this come from? Well, there was a Scottish inventor by the name of James Watt, and he's a contemporary of Mozart and Benjamin Franklin. So that kind of puts you in that time frame, right around the early 1800s. And he developed a steam engine. Now, he perfected a steam engine. It was a good piece. And he wanted to sell his steam engine, but he would go out to a farm and they were using horses on a grain grinder, a mill. And the farmer had no concept of what this steam engine could do. So James had to somehow equate what the farmers understood, which was the output of their horses, to what his engine could produce. So he went out and he sort of studied what the farmers were doing. So they would have this big, huge grinding wheel sitting on top of another one with a big arm coming out from it. Say that was 12 feet. They would hook a horse to it and the horse would walk around in a circle and just rotate this huge stone on there and they'd feed grain into it. That's the way it worked. So what James did was he measured the amount of pull that the horse had to pull, which was 180 pounds. He figured he watched the horse walk around 144 times in 1 hour. That works out to be about 2.4 revolutions per minute. So he knew the circumference, because circumference is 2 pi r. So he could figure out how far the horse moved and what its pull was. So now he could calculate power. So power for this horse was the circumference of the circle, 2 pi r. R is 12 feet. So 2 times pi times 12, great. And then it pulled 180 pounds, so times 180. And then it rotated at 2.4 RPMs. Multiply that all out, and you get 32,572 is what you get, 32,000. So that number was a little bit difficult to work with, so a little bit, they had to round that up. So they rounded it up to 33,000 foot-pounds, and that was about the year 1783 or so. So now James had a conversion factor that he could apply that a farmer would understand, because he knew exactly what his horses could do, and he could put multiple horses on a job. So James knew that if he could say, well, my steam engine puts out X horsepower, then that was a scaling factor that the farmer understood. So that's really all it is. So let's go into the derivation of how you actually calculate horsepower for a car. So with a car, you'd put it on a dynamometer or maybe a rolling road or something if you wanted to measure wheel horsepower. Or if you look in your owner's manual, I know for the 356, they have torque curves and RPM and horsepower curves, which is really great. So going back to horsepower, we know that horsepower is calculated. All we need to do is measure the RPM and the torque, and that's it. So let's go through that whole derivation and figure out how we get to horsepower equals torque times RPM over 5252. Let's see where that 5252 comes from. In order to derive the horsepower equation of horsepower equals torque times RPM over 5252, we're going to need a few equations. So this is a little like the tools and supplies we'll need. Torque equals force times the radius, and work is force through a distance. The next thing we'll need is the circumference of a circle, which is 2 pi r radians, or 2 pi r. Then RPM, which is rotations per minute, and then velocity, which is equal to distance over time. And if you work it out, velocity also equals 2 pi r, which is the circumference, times RPM. So that will give you the linear velocity of a rotating wheel. We have power, which equals work over time. And finally, we have our definition of horsepower, which is 33,000 foot-pounds per minute. All right, so let's see how this all comes together. Starting with our power equation of power equals work over time, we know that work is just force times distance, and that'd be over time. So we know velocity is distance over time, so we can get to power equals force times velocity, all right? So now with power equals force times velocity, we can start substituting the force and the velocity and keep moving on. So let's work with the velocity first. And from above, we have velocity equals 2 pi r times RPM, so we'll go ahead and substitute that in. Next, we need a force. Now remember that torque is force times radius, so that means that the force equals the torque divided by the radius. All right, simple enough. So if we put it all together, we get power equals torque over radius times 2 pi r times RPM. Great, look at that. Our r's then cancel out, which gives us the equation of power equals torque times 2 pi times RPM in foot-pounds per minute. All right, well that gives us our power equation, but we still don't have our horsepower equation. Remember I said in the beginning that horsepower is nothing more than a conversion. It's just 33,000 foot-pounds per minute. It's a lot like meters to kilometers. So if you had 4,000 meters, you'd divide by 1,000 to get 4 kilometers. We're going to do the same sort of thing here. So our power equation there, and we're doing a little dimensional analysis here. With 1 horsepower over 33,000 foot-pounds per minute, those foot-pounds per minute cancel out, which gives us horsepower equals torque times 2 pi times RPM divided by 33,000. Now, rearranging just a little bit, we get torque times RPM times 2 pi over 33,000. Once again, putting that 2 pi on the bottom of the 33,000, we get torque times RPM over 33,000 divided by 2 pi. And that gets us our horsepower equals torque times RPM divided by 5252. So that's where that equation comes from. Okay, so some final thoughts here. So we've got this equation, right? We've got horsepower equals torque times RPM divided by 5252. So if you've got a graph of your output of your engine or any power source, really, and it's got RPM along the bottom, and you've got torque on one side and horsepower on the other in the same units at the same scale, you'll notice that those graphs will cross at 5252. They always will, because Horsepower is torque times RPM over 5252, and if the RPM is 5252, then guess what? They cancel out, and you get torque equals horsepower. Simple enough. So that's kind of interesting. The what that also says, though, is that if the RPM is zero, then you'll have no horsepower. So you've probably heard the statement that an electric motor puts out max torque at stall. Same thing with a steam engine, interestingly enough. But that means also if there's no movement, there is zero horsepower. So it might put out its maximum torque, but it's going to put out zero horsepower at that point. It's not until that shaft starts to turn that we get any work accomplished, and then the work over time is power. So that's interesting. And then on the other end of that, if the engine puts out zero torque, then the horsepower is zero, doesn't matter what the RPM is. So that would be a point at which either the electric motor or the piston engine is spinning so fast that its output is, it's every bit of power that it puts out is going into actually spinning the motor or spinning the engine. So at that point, the output torque is zero. So it doesn't matter what the RPM is. So those graphs will always drop off and you'll see torque go down to zero. So that's that. Another very important thing I think to remember is that since horsepower is calculated, it's not some magical thing. It's literally just the output of an equation. So if you have two different engines and they both at the same RPM produce exactly the same torque, they will produce the same horsepower. So I think that's very important to understand. There's not some magical thing like, oh, I can build this engine that puts out this torque at this RPM and it puts out this horsepower, and I can build this other engine with the same torque and RPM and it puts out a different horsepower. That's not possible because it's from an equation. Now, outside of those ranges, if they don't line up, of course it's going to be different. But if they do line up for those two points, the horsepower will always be the same. So really getting back to this is just, horsepower is just a conversion factor. It's really just a marketing term that was used by James Watt to sell his steam engines to farmers. And farmers could know that, okay, I need to put three Shire horses or three brewery horses on this one particular thing for this grain or this, whatever they're using it for. And James could say, well, then what you need is an engine that puts out three horsepower. So that was kind of cool. So it was actually kind of brilliant, but it's very old. And so I think the preferred power unit now would be watts, which is interesting. It's named after James Watt. Isn't that funny? So that's the SI units for it. And I believe in Europe, you can let me know if I'm wrong, but I believe that the standard units in Europe are watts, and that if you're going to give the output of an engine or electric motor or whatever, you're going to put it in watts. And then if you want to apply horsepower, it has to be a secondary specification for the engine. So that's kind of interesting, I think. And the nice thing about watts is that it travels well across mechanical to electrical power. It's 1 watt times one watt is 1 volt times 1 ampere. Super simple. So that's why I think, all in all, I think that's why horsepower is really just horse poo. So I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you got questions and comments, I'm sure there'll be a bunch of them. Go ahead and leave them down below and we'll get into a big old discussion. It'll be really fun. So I hope you enjoyed it. It was really kind of fun for me to go back. I was so confused about a lot of this, and I'd watched a zillion different videos and things, and it just wasn't gelling for me. So I wanted to go back to the math, and that's where I was like, oh my gosh, it's just a conversion factor. Super simple. So if you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up, and thank you so much for watching, and until next time, safe travels. Bye.